Hey guys, welcome back to Chit Chatterday. So today's video, I wanted to share with you what I do for skincare. I haven't done a skincare video on my channel. Like, I've mentioned things that I've used, and I used to do empties videos. I apologize if you like those, but I have a hard time hanging on to trash. I truly do. Most of the time, I share things with you that I'm liking anyways, but today I wanted to do a dedicated skincare routine. It's going to be a lot of products because I use different things in the day versus the night, and then I have like trickling in like, oh, I did forget one thing. That is okay. I will just mention it. Things that I do like weekly and stuff like that. So I wanted to just sit down today and share with you everything that I do. And so this is going to be probably a little lengthier chit-chatter day today, but I don't want to miss anything, just so that you have a point of reference. This has kind of been my routine now. Well, most of these products I bought last summer-ish, so we're getting to the end of a lot of things. Some things I'll be replenishing or trying new things and whatever. Anyways, we'll get into that. So I want to start with daytime. No, I'm going to start with taking my makeup off. So what I use to take my makeup off. I like to use a cleanse, like a makeup breakup type of situation before I go in and cleanse my face. What I mean by that is sometimes I'll use makeup removers. I currently have a couple packages left from Costco. You can buy the Kirkland brand makeup remover wipes. Those are wonderful. You can buy a giant tub of them. If you don't have access to Costco, the other ones I really like are the lavender. I'll insert a picture here. I believe they're like lavender Olay ones or something. Anyways, they suds up nicely. They smell great. They don't irritate my eyes. Some of them irritate my eyes, but I do like those two makeup cleansing cloths. Those are what I use in a pinch or if I'm traveling, but what I prefer to use is something like this, like a cleansing off oil. This is the Bobbi Brown Soothing Cleansing Oil. Let's see, it has kookookie nut. Kookookie, that's cute. Or is it kukui? Kukui? I don't know. Nut and sunflower oils and jasmine flower. Looks like this. You just need like one or two pumps and that's enough for your whole face. It's gentle enough to scrub off your eye area, like your mascara and everything. I don't wear waterproof mascara, so I can't tell you if this is good enough for that. But I like to use something like this because I like to break up and get rid of all the makeup and loosen it up. Then I take a warm washcloth and wash that off. Then I go in with my cleanser. So that is my preferred method to take off my makeup. An eye makeup remover that I want to mention that is my favorite one is the Chanel Gentle Biphase Eye Makeup Remover. This works beautifully. All you need is a cotton round, which these are the cotton rounds I currently am using. I like the Shiseido cotton rounds, but I got sent these from my friend Lisa, and she sent me the Quo brand, which are very, very similar. Now, these are only available in Canada, but I like these because I've, you know, the ones that you can get at, say, Target or Walmart or whatever, they like are not thick enough. They like break apart. They leave all the cotton everywhere and it's just a hot mess. These are square. They're thicker. They're very soft. You just need a little bit of product. This covers more surface area. I love this type of thing. So the Shiseido ones would be the equivalent to these. And then you just need a tiny amount of this and it's enough for both eyes. This stuff is really, it works really well, which is why I've only used probably this much, because I really only use this if A, I wear waterproof mascara, or B, I wear something that, like a mascara that's really tough to get off with even, say, this. Then I'll go in with my eye makeup remover. So this is kind of spendy, so I like to like savor it for those really severe situations and just not use something like this on the daily, especially when you don't need to. Okay, so at nighttime, that's how I take off my makeup. Then I have a couple cleansers here. So at nighttime, I like to use an exfoliating cleanser because I've worn makeup. I want to make sure that all of it is out of my pores so I don't get breakouts, don't get blackheads, stuff like that. So the cleanser I've been using for exfoliating is this. It's actually literally almost gone. Is the Obagi exfoliating cleanser. Looks like this. This is nice. It's in a gel base. It's very calming, does not irritate my skin. I do have kind of sensitive skin when it comes to trying a lot of new products for skincare. So I think all of these are definitely good for you if you have sensitive skin. Let's see. This says to use twice daily. I don't see a reason to use it twice, especially if you exfoliate once at nighttime. There's no need to wake up in the morning and exfoliate your face when all you've done is slept. Yeah, I like it. Let's see. It gently yet thoroughly cleans your skin to reveal a soft, smooth, radiant complexion. It really does. It's not a harsh scrub. It's in like this clear gel. Smells really fresh, really nice. Can you see? It's great. I really enjoyed this one. So that is the cleanser. Okay. So that is the cleanser I use at nighttime. Now before, well, let's just continue with nighttime. I'm like kind of all over the place because I have it all set up, but then I'm like, Okay, so after I cleanse my face, if needed, if I feel like my skin just doesn't look right, or if I don't use the exfoliating cleanser and use just a regular cleanser, I'll go in with a toner just to make sure everything is completely out, because I am very prone to blackheads here on my nose and in between my eyebrows. And truthfully, if I skip exfoliating or toning for a while, I get blackheads and they're gross. They just look gross, you know what I mean? I don't know. So this is the toner I like. I've repurchased this a few times. The Mario Badescu Aloe Vera Toner. I like this one because it doesn't have alcohol in it. Alcohol dries my skin out so bad. It's very irritating. It makes it red and just kind of like, yo, what are you doing? So I love this one. It's very gentle. It's great for sensitive skin. Let's see. Aloe Vera helps calm and condition the complexion. Yeah, it's just a very calming. It works well. I put a little bit on one of these cotton pads and cleanse, make sure I cleanse down my neck, because I bring my foundation down because for some reason I get a lot of breakouts under here, and then I have it's like white here and then tan, so I like to bring my, not like put makeup there, but you've seen me, you just kind of blend it down or whatever. So I like to make sure that I use the toner from my neck up. So okay, we're done with the toner. All right, let's move into the, after we've cleansed our skin and we've toned our skin, it's prepped for skincare. So I started retinol in the fall, and I did it way too quickly, and my skin like totally freaked out because I knew nothing about retinol. All I know is everyone on here was saying, you need to be using it. Okay, so you buy it, and then you have no idea how to use it, and you have a reaction, you freak out, and you stop using it for about, I stopped using it for about a month and a half, 2 months. Then I watched a few videos. I decided to educate myself instead of just like, you know what I mean? Sometimes I can just be so dumb. I watched a few videos, and it's something you have to work up to. And Angie from Hot and Flashy, she's very knowledgeable when it comes to skincare. I definitely recommend her channel if you are new to skincare or you want to get into a good routine, but it's so overwhelming. Or if you're unfamiliar with your skin type, or you know what your skin type is and you're not sure what to use, I would reference her channel because she's helped me out a lot. I don't know if she knows that, but anyways. So I watched her and she said it's something you need to work up to. So we're talking one day a week for a month. Second month, 2 times a week for a month. The third month, 3 times a week. So I probably could, I've been using this now, I could probably go up to 4 times a week, but I've kind of stayed at the 3 times a week just because I have to be really careful with retinol. I've figured out that if I go too much, I literally just wake up and just rash and irritate a little bumps, and it's just, it's not good. It almost looks worse than not using it, you know? And that's not the point of retinol. Retinol is supposed to help even out that your skin texture and make your skin look youthful and glowy and just like a baby's bottom, right? So this is what I've been using, the Obagi Medical, let's see, this is 0.5%. I also have, when I'm done with this, I'm going to move in, I purchased a kit off QVC from Peter Thomas Roth. It's his retinol, it's in a serum dropper, and it's a little bit more than this, so I'm hoping I'll be able to go into that transition, but we shall see. Anyways, I use this 3 times a week right now, Tuesday, Friday, and Sunday nights. After you cleanse your skin, this is the first thing I put on. You don't need very much, and I put it all in here and on my forehead. I think you're supposed to avoid like the mouth area and definitely the eye area, but you know, like the main parts of where your skin would have texture. So this, gradually releases retinol, refining the appearance of skin texture and tone for a clearer looking skin. Definitely have seen a difference using this, but like I said, go slow. This is not something you can just dive into using every day or you will have issues. Okay, so as far as moisturizer, I've been the Sahara the past couple months. It's been off and on winter here, and we're going into spring now, but it literally had a blizzard this past weekend, so my skin's like all over the place. So I've been really dry. So I've been really focusing on more like oils and serums at nighttime, because when I'm sleeping, I need the moisture. Because I've used night creams, and if it's not strong enough, I'll wake up in the morning and my skin is taut and dry. It's crazy. So the sign of a good moisturizer, if you wake up in the morning and you look plump and radiant and full, I mean, if you wake up and your skin's all dry, then that's not a hard enough working moisturizer for you. So one thing I've been using is argan oil. I usually have the big, huge 4-ounce bottle of the Josie Maran Argan Oil. I use that up. I do prefer her light version if you're going to use it during the daytime. At nighttime, though, I just go full-on grease. But you wake up looking good in the morning. But I'm using up this one. This one's from Pure Dior Body, Face, and Hair Treatment. You can put this, I've actually used it for an all-over body moisturizer, which you're going to go through it fast that way, but when you're super dry, like, whatever. I'll use it as a hair treatment, too, like an overnight, put it in your scalp and run it through and then wash it out in the morning. So any sort of argan oil is great. I prefer the Josie Maran one over this, but it works to moisturize my skin. Sorry, I had to check my time because I was like, oh my gosh, my battery! So I like to use this. I also mix this in with my foundations if I'm really dry. Use this on my hands. This is like a multi-purpose product, so it's just a great, really good moisturizer. Now, on the flip side of that, if you want your hair to be clean in the morning, you're going to either need to wash it or put it up, because it's an oil, so it's going to get into your hair if you have bangs or whatever. I don't care if I'm not going anywhere, but if I'm going somewhere, I tend to go for more like a night cream versus an oil. But anyways, this is what I've been using lately, so I wanted to share that. Now in the summertime, I'll probably use less heavy things and a little lighter things. We shall see. I know it just really depends. And it depends where you live too and the climate you're in. Like if you're in a humid climate, you're probably not going to need this, you know? The other one I really like, and this is not oily like this. This is the Pericone MD Chia Serum. This is super, super hydrating, but non-greasy, and it absorbs quickly. So this says on the back of here that how I use it is I use it on cleansed skin as like my moisturizer. But it says you can also use it on top of your makeup after. You put on makeup like as like just like kind of patted in to give your skin moisture or whatever. I have never tried that. But I wanted to read to you, I wrote down, it says it protects against moisture loss, superior nourishment, and hydration. That's directly from his website. And I bought this in a duo off of QVC. They completely sold it to me. I guess chia serum is really good. And it smells kind of unique. I like it. I don't know. It's nutty. It smells like a nut. But it's beautiful. So I'm actually, you can see that. I'm almost out of this one. And I'm going to open up my next one here. But this, when I wake up in the morning, my skin is plump. It's hydrated. It almost looks clear. I don't know. It really does work. That's all I know. Okay. Then I have this product. This is a nighttime mask. This is the overnight hydration mask. This is something I've been incorporating into my skincare routine at nighttime, 2 to 3 times a week, depending on how dry my skin feels. So after you know, put on your night cream or your oils or serums, whatever it is that you're using, you put this on top of it. It kind of seals the deal. Adds in extra moisture and keeps your skin completely hydrated. It's an overnight mask. It smells good. It's a very fresh, clean type of smell, and it's like a gel, so it's not heavy. It's not like adding a heavy cream, thick mask on top of what you've already done. It's very lightweight, and it really, it has these little beads in it, and as you massage it into your skin, they like dissipate into your skin, and it just is really like a nice lightweight gel like mask that seals the deal, gives you that added hydration overnight. I think it feels wonderful. So if you're someone who's like, I have oily skin, I don't want to do that, it's still important to do that, you know, so your skin doesn't overcompensate and produce more than it needs to. What else did I want to, oh, I saved the box for this too. I wanted to read to you, it says, because I just got this. I've been using this for about 2 weeks now. And let's see. It says, formulated with encapsulated hyaluronic acid, which is essentially water, shea butter beads, and plant ceramide, the intensive yet ultra-light, fast-absorbing sleep treatment deeply rehydrates, replumps the look of skin overnight. Clinically shown to boost a skin's moisture by 3 times immediately and deliver 48 hours of hydration. I think it's lovely. It's really nice. And this is a more affordable skincare product compared to, say, some of the other things that I'm showing you here. But just keep in mind, you get one face, get one crack at it to take care of your face, your skin. And I honestly would trade in all of this makeup for a really awesome skincare that I can see results with, because your makeup's going to perform better and you're going to feel more confident when your skin, you know, it starts with your skin. Like, I used to really not want to walk out the house without makeup on because I didn't have the greatest skin. I didn't take care of it right. I didn't really know what to do. But now that I do take care of my skin, I feel confident walking out and just having good skin and letting my skin breathe. So anyways, okay, so that's my nighttime skincare routine. Another thing I will incorporate into my nighttime skincare routine, if I'm not going to do a exfoliator and I just want to wash my face, is the Clarisonic. I don't use this daily. It's too harsh for me. I do buy the sensitive head. You can buy different heads. This is the Clarisonic Plus, which I'm not sure if they make this one anymore, but it does come with an attachment for the body. I've never used it for my body. I just use it for my face. And a great place to buy these, besides like Sephora and Nordstrom and stuff like that, is QVC, because they offer kits usually. And every year, I can't remember what time of year it is, but they always, always do a today's special value with the Clarisonic. Great time to pick it up. And I think they recently did it, though. It was the Mia, which is smaller, and they did like a 2-for-1. Anyways, I do like to use this. I do like to use it after, say, some weeks I wear more makeup than others. The past 2 weeks, I've only worn makeup like, maybe like 3 or 4 times. And then there's other weeks where I'll wear it daily. So those weeks where I wear a lot of makeup, I like to use the Clarisonic because I feel like it really does get my skin cleaner than a washcloth can, or than my hands can. It really can get into the nooks and crannies and clean out your pores, which is really important, because otherwise, like I said before, you'll get breakouts, you'll get blackheads. You know, makeup just sitting in your skin overnight is just not a good thing. Like, it just can cause a lot of problems that you'll then have to try to reverse. So I like to incorporate the Clarisonic because I really see a difference when I wear a lot of makeup, that this helps get all the makeup off. And you don't want to be like treating your skin with makeup still sitting on it. Think about that. That's gross. Okay. So now I've slept and it's morning. And in the morning, your face isn't dirty. You just slept overnight with all these treatments on it. There's no need to like wake up and scrub it, really. Maybe a little water, a really soft, gentle cleanse or something like that. But what I've been going to lately is the Garnier Skin Active Micellar Cleansing Water. So basically, it just gets off the treatments or any dirt or dust or dust bunnies that fell on your face while you were sleeping. It's always a creepy thought to think, like, or when you wake up and you see like a spider or something, it like, okay, sometimes I drool. Did that spider go in my mouth? You know what I mean? Like, that's like that go into my mind. Anyways, I just take a cotton round and do that in the morning. I don't see a reason to really go crazy and waste cleanser and all that when this is just going to get off your treatments, and then you can go on in with your morning skincare routine. No rinse, no harsh rubbing. I've been using this. I'm really impressed with it. They do sell one with a blue cap for waterproof makeup, which you might want to try and buy, like, if you wear waterproof makeup, or maybe use that one when you take off your makeup at night. But I like to use this in the morning. It's just, feels great. It's just like this wet little thing. Okay, it just feels great in the morning. I just like the way that it feels. Kind of wakes up my skin. The other non-exfoliating cleanser, so as far as cleansers, I use the exfoliating one, and then this is my non-exfoliating cleanser. So say I feel like washing my face, or I get up in the morning and I go straight to doing a workout and I don't wash my face, because what's the point? Then after my workout or shower or whatever, I'll wash my face. And this is the cleanser I've been using for quite some time. It lives in my shower, which is why the packaging's all weird. But this is the Dr. Woods Black Soap Facial Cleanser for all skin types. I buy this off of Vitacost. Let's see, antioxidant formula with shea butter. So this is great. Gently exfoliates, heals blemishes, neutralizes free radicals, moisturizes, and conditions. A lot of cleansers, after I use them, my face will feel tight and taut. And that means it just dehydrated the crap out of your skin. And this does not do that. I feel cleansed. As far as the scent goes, it's kind of like a natural medicinal type scent. Not awesome, but who cares? You're just washing your face and it goes down the drain. So black soap is a gentle exfoliant to help rejuvenate skin cells and clear blemishes. And then it has an, let's see, gamma tocopherol, which is a form of vitamin E that helps nourish and repair the skin. Shea butters, moisturizing, botanical extracts. Like it has chamomile, lavender, rosemary, peppermint, and tea tree in it. Vegan, natural. There's pretty much just nothing in here. And it cleanses your skin. So I enjoy this cleanser. I get this off of Vitacost. This is 8 fluid ounces. This has lasted me a long time. I just noticed that my camera wasn't recording and now I have no idea where I was. But I was basically telling you I've used it down to here. I would definitely repurchase this. It's just a nice, easy cleanser with no added junk in it. So now we're moving into my skincare routine for the morning, daytime type thing. So the first thing I apply is the Pericone MD Blue Plasma. This is a daily peel. And what a daily peel does is you are going to want to put this on your face first, before treatments, before moisturizers. This is the first thing that hits cleanse skin. I want to read to you what it does. I took this off of the website because I wanted to make sure, I'm not an expert on skincare, but I wanted to make sure that I say what the product does and not skip over it. So it delivers luminosity, smoothness, clarity, and brightens for youthful looking skin. It's also great for fine lines, loss of firmness, large pores. So basically, this just kind of is a clean slate, really preps your skin for your moisturizer and any other treatments and makeup. So if you have any of those things, fine lines, loss of luminosity, loss of firmness, heck, we're all aging, right? We're not getting younger. This is a great product. I really can feel the difference and see the difference when I look in the mirror after putting this on my face. So it's a daily peel, which is nice. It's gentle. Like I said, I need gentle things, and so this is what I use. Now, something that does the same exact thing, but is for your eye area. This is for your face, right? This is for the eyes. This is the Blue Plasma Orbital. It's like a gel. This is almost gone. I forgot, this is liquid. You obviously saw that. It comes in a dropper, so you just drop some in your palm, and then I even take it down to my neck, because don't neglect your neck. I do not want a turkey neck. I do not want a turkey gobbler. Like, I already know there's serious sun damage here, and I can see the signs of that from my earlier days of my life. And so don't neglect skipping treating your neck. So I like to take a lot of my products down, so you use them up, but once, like I said, you only get one chance at it. So this is like a gel formula. This has lasted me forever. This is a once a day thing. You don't need to do this at nighttime. I have been doing it at nighttime just because, as you probably noticed, I don't have an eye cream right now. I don't even have any backups of anything. I'm just kind of like testing the waters, reading to see what I really want to buy next, because skincare is expensive. So I don't want to just buy something and then have it just be pointless, not work for me. So I'm kind of waiting to see what I'm going to get there, but this is what I've been using in the meantime. It does the same thing, helps with fine lines, wrinkles. It feels really good because it's like this gel material. Keep in mind, if you're not familiar with Pericone's products, they do smell funky. It goes away, but they smell like that because they have live ingredients in them. And that's okay with me, because if it's working, I can deal with the smell. You know what I mean? And it doesn't linger. It's not, some of his stuff, like the other thing I used up that I would have been in here, but I just recently used it, was the, what's it called? Photoplasma. And that fights the 10 signs of aging, like loss of firmness, elasticity, dullness, clarity, pores, all that type of thing. You put that on after the daily peel and before your moisturizer. And that is a product I've brought to you before. I've talked about it, I think, 2 or 3 times. Love that product as well. But I used it up, which is why it's not here. So anyways, those are like the treatment things that I do. And then the last thing that I put on my face is my daily moisturizer. I cannot stress to you enough, you need to use a daily moisturizer with SPF in it. A minimum of 30, ideally. This one has 30. This is the MD Solar Sciences Daily Anti-Aging Moisturizer Broad Spectrum SPF. I forgot to mention, but all these products will be linked below in case you're curious where to purchase them. I will link them for you. This I got last summer. This is a great moisturizer. Here's the thing with daily moisturizers with SPF. You're thinking, well, SPF is greasy. Yeah, it is. And some moisturizers are just downright too greasy. They make your hair greasy, your makeup slides off, it doesn't look good. I can tell you, I've been using this every day since last summer, and it's literally, I need to buy a new one. This works well with makeup, and I wear all kinds of foundation, all kinds of things. This is what I'm wearing. It is not greasy. It absorbs into the skin quickly. I think it has a lavender, let's see, yeah, natural lavender botanical essence. It smells great. Mineral oil free. It's great for all skin types. It's lightweight, but yet it gives you the SPF. It gives you the moisture. It's very hydrating. I don't think it's a super thick, you don't want a super thick daytime moisturizer because, like I said, it's not going to work with your makeup and you're just going to look like greasy. And I just, I can't. At nighttime, I don't care. I'm just going to bed. But during the daytime, I don't want to look like a grease bomb. Let's see. Antioxidants, moisturizers, and skin repair agents help to restore brightness and minimize the appearance of fine lines and wrinkles for younger looking skin. I've been really enjoying this moisturizer. I think it's been working quite well for me. So, and it plays well with my other products, because sometimes you'll get things and they just don't really work together and they'll like ball up and react and your skin's like flaking off and you're like, what's going on? It's just the ingredients and the products you're using aren't like, they're not friends. They're not making friends. They're quarreling. So that is going to do it for all of my skincare things that I use. If you have any questions, please leave them down below for me. If you have any product recommendations for an eye cream, I would love to know what is hydrating, not too thick, good for like fine lines, because I have a lot of fine lines and it can't be too thick because then it doesn't work with my concealer, you know what I mean? So a good eye cream recommendation would be awesome. I would love that. So I hope you guys have a great rest of your day. Thank you so much for chatting with me. And on Monday, I will have up my Sephora VIB sale haul. So I wanted to get that up, but I wanted to get this up because I, like I said, I have not shared much skincare on my channel and I thought it's time. Chelsea, you've been on here for 2.5 years and I don't even know what you're putting on your face. So anyways, if you guys enjoyed this, give this video a thumbs up and yeah, I will chit chat with you guys soon. Bye.